In this example, we are given that a uniform disk of radius r is first spinned about its axis to the angular speed omega, and then it is carefully placed with a flat face on a rough horizontal surface. And we are required to find how long will the disk be rotating on the surface if the friction coefficient is mu. In this situation, if we analyze the case, we can state due to friction, it will experience an opposing torque. So if we draw the top view of the disk, which is rotating at an angular speed omega, I'm just drawing the top view of this disk. So in this situation, at every point tangentially, friction will act in opposite direction. To analyze the friction, let's consider a small elemental ring, which is of width dx, and it is of radius x, which I've drawn here. So at every point of it, due to its anticlockwise motion, the friction will act on it in clockwise direction. And say I denote this friction by df. So to calculate the value of this friction, first I'll find the mass of elemental ring. This mass of elemental ring dm can be written as, let's consider its mass as m. So the mass of this elemental ring can be written as the mass per unit area, that is m by pi r square multiplied by the area occupied by the ring, which is 2 pi x dx. Now in this situation, pi gets cancelled out, I'll get the mass of this ring. And the force of friction which is tangentially acting on it can be written as mu dm g. Because the normal reaction total will be mg, but the contribution in normal reaction due to the weight of the string will be mu dmg. That is dmg, so friction will be mu dmg. So in this situation, if I calculate the torque due to ring is, we are talking about friction torque due to ring is d tau, which can be written as df into x. Because this friction is acting at a radius x from the center of ring. So total torque also we can calculate by integrating this, integration of d tau, that is integration of alpha, substitute the value of df, that is m by r square into 2x dx multiplied by this x into mu g. I'll substitute the whole df as well as this x, and I'll integrate it from 0 to r. Now in this situation, carefully I just take all constants out of the sign of integration. So this will be 2 m mu g by r square. It is integration of x square dx from 0 to r. If I integrate this expression, the integration of x square will be x cube by 3. If I substitute the value of r, it will be 2 m mu g by r square into r cube by 3. This r square gets cancelled out. So the torque I am getting is 2 by 3 m mu g r. So this is the torque. Due to the net torque acting on disk due to friction, it will be retarded by an angular deceleration, which can be given as here angular deceleration is torque upon I. So moment of inertia of the disk we can take as half mr square in this situation. So this can be written as 2 by 3 m mu g r upon half mr square. You can see now m gets cancelled out and the value of angular acceleration, precisely I must say angular deceleration, we can get here as 4 by 3 mu g by r. Now if I wish to find out the time after which the disk will come to rest, I'll use the basic speed equations for motion, that is omega final is omega initial plus alpha t. So here final angular speed will be 0 when it will come to rest, and initial I can use as the given angular speed omega. So from here I can write the time will be equals to omega by alpha, which can be directly given as, if I just substitute the value of alpha here, it will be 3 omega r by 4 mu g, that will be the answer to our problem.